Good afternoon, and welcome to Immaculate Conception Church. Please mute all mobile devices. Today we celebrate Mass for the 23rd Sunday in Ordinary Time, and this Mass is being offered for George de Bruyn, Jr. Our opening hymn is Praise My Soul, the King of Heaven, and we're going to do verses 1 through 3. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, we are gathered here this evening, grateful to God for this opportunity to come together, already here on this third day of the month of September, a day which the Universal Church celebrates St. Gregory the Great, one of the four saints depicted around the corners here, around the crucifix, what are known as the four Western doctors, or the four great Western doctors, with St. Ambrose, St. Augustine, St. Jerome, and then St. Gregory the Great. In addition to that, within our local church, today is the birthday of Archbishop Hebda. So we hold our local bishop up in our prayers, as well as anyone else whose birthday it might be, if they're participating in our liturgy this evening. We ourselves are all participating here, active in person, and those joining us virtually. Grateful for all that God has done and is doing within our lives. At the beginning of this Mass, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you came to reconcile us to the Father and to one another. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you strengthen us in holiness through word and sacrament. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you lead us, your people, in the path of salvation. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Give you thanks for your great glory.
Let us pray. O God, by whom we are redeemed and receive adoption, look graciously upon your beloved sons and daughters, that those who believe in Christ may receive true freedom and an everlasting inheritance. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Book of Wisdom. Who can know God's counsel, or who can conceive what the Lord intends? For the deliberations of mortals are timid, and unsure are our plans. For the corruptible body burdens the soul, and the earthen shelter weighs down the mind that has many concerns. And scarce do we guess the things on earth, and what is within our grasp we find with difficulty. But when things are in heaven, who can search them out? Or whoever knew your counsel, except you, had given wisdom and sent your Holy Spirit from on high? And thus were the paths of those on earth made straight. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from the letter of St. Paul to Philemon. I, Paul, an old man, and now also a prisoner for Christ Jesus, urge you on behalf of my child Onesimus, whose father I have become in my imprisonment. I am sending him, that is, my own heart, back to you. I should have liked to retain him for myself, so that he might serve me on your behalf in my imprisonment for the gospel. But I did not want to do anything without your consent, so that the good you do might not be forced, but voluntary. Perhaps this is why he was away from you for a while, that you might have him back forever, no longer as a slave, but more than a slave, a brother, beloved especially to me, but even more so to you, as a man and in the Lord. So if you regard me as a partner, welcome him as you would me. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Great crowds were traveling with Jesus, and he turned and addressed them. If anyone comes to me without hating his father and mother, wife and children, brothers and sisters, and even his own life, he cannot be my disciple. Whoever does not carry his own cross and come after me cannot be my disciple. Which of you, wishing to construct a tower, does not first sit down and calculate the cost to see if there is enough for its completion? Otherwise, after laying the foundation and finding himself unable to finish the work, the onlookers should laugh at him and say, "This one began to build but did not have the resources to finish." For what king marching into battle would not first sit down and decide whether with 10,000 troops he can successfully oppose another king advancing upon him with 20,000 troops? But if not, while he is still far away, he will send a delegation to ask for peace terms. In the same way, any of you who does not renounce all his possessions cannot be my disciple. The Gospel of the Lord. As we ourselves, as a faithful body of believers, travel on the seas of the world, it's good that we've got a steady and sturdy boat to keep us going. Certainly within the church, it's been metaphorically and understood as a boat or a ship passing on the waves of the world through time itself. But something else that we look to is a discipleship and perhaps friendship and other sorts of words that end in ship. I think I've talked about this publicly before, maybe you've looked into it yourselves. That suffix within the English language, it means a state of being. So whenever we see the prefix, the word leading into it, whether it's friend, disciple, worksman, or sportsman, whatever it is, it means that's the state of being. And so we ourselves, we're gathered here in this body of believers in this discipleship. Jesus talked within the gospel at great length about those who could not be his disciples. Now, this wasn't to exclude and it wasn't meant to put down any of those particular categories that Jesus was talking about. I'll go a bit into length about what I wrote about within the bulletin. So if you're wondering or seem confounded by what I'm talking about, you can look at the bulletin for this weekend. It's right there in my article about the four different kind of hindrances that there can be to our journey of discipleship. But also, these could be ways in which we could grow in our discipleship, our friendship with the Lord and those around us. So those four different areas that Jesus enunciated or articulated there within the gospel, we have family, our life circumstances, suffering, and our possessions. in and of themselves, with maybe the exception of suffering, are really good things. Family and the life circumstances we have and our possessions are all gifts and can be used at the service of the Lord and one another. But when we have such a hyper focus on any one of these areas, that's when our boat starts to sink. We ourselves don't have that same sort of free-flowing discipleship. So we look to Christ to ask for his grace and his support as we journey as his disciples. Just a bit of a grammatical, etymological clarification about something that I read within the gospel for today, which maybe you've wondered about it and maybe it caused a bit of concern for you. When Jesus talked about hating mother and father or family or friends or even hating your own life. Now, the original Greek of the New Testament there in hating is not as we understand it in English as actively and vehemently being against something. Hatred in this context from the Greek, it means to love less than. But again, if you translate that into English, it kind of almost sounds like it's softening the message of Jesus when he was trying to garner the attention of his followers and those who were around him. So we ourselves, indeed, were called to love less anything else that doesn't help us to grow ultimately in our discipleship with Christ and with those around us. Our family, our life circumstances, our job, our friendships, those hobbies that we have, our suffering that we encounter, all of those possessions that we have or don't have, all of these different moments can be those touchstone grace opportunities for us to grow in this life of discipleship. And so we reflect upon that at the personal level and think, Lord, how am I doing? How am I doing in my relationship with you, my discipleship? How is it that I am with my family, with my life circumstances? When those moments of suffering come my way, do I embrace that cross or do I push it away as far as can be? And with those possessions I have or don't have, do I use them well? Am I grateful for them or do I continually grasp for more and more? We reflect on that at the personal level, at the communal level, and ask that with God's grace, we ourselves would press onward in this discipleship journey together. So that one day after going through the seas of this life, we ourselves would make it to the safe harbor of the heavenly kingdom. To praise God in his grace and mercy forever and ever. As one family of believers, let us together profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We turn to God, our Heavenly Father, with all of our prayers and petitions this evening.
That our Pope, our bishops, our clergy, and religious may continue to show forth an example of discipleship, we pray to the Lord. Amen. That developing countries may not lose sight of God's will for human happiness in a quest for prosperity, we pray to the Lord. Amen. That those who struggle with addictions or emotional illness may learn to walk in the steps of Jesus Christ, we pray to the Lord. for our Immaculate Conception Church community, we may have the grace to shoulder our crosses without complaining. We pray to the Lord. For George de Bruin, Jr., for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord. For those who are ill, especially Barb Rosek, those on our prayer chain and in our books of intention, may they be touched by the healing power of Jesus. We pray to the Lord. For those who have died, especially Mary Munns, sister of Joanne Christensen, our loved ones and all who have died as a result of violence, may they rejoice with the Lord in heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Heavenly Father, we come before you this day grateful for the mercy of your Son, Jesus, who teaches us and accompanies us in this journey of discipleship. We ask you would send forth your Holy Spirit to strengthen us and support one another with our words and actions. Help us to be a people of prayer. We make all of our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who give us the gift of true prayer and of peace, graciously grant that through this offering we may do fitting homage to your divine majesty, and by partaking of the sacred mystery, we may be faithfully united in mind and heart through Christ our Lord. Lord be with you.
And with
lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Bernard, our Bishop, Joseph, his assistant, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. We may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who sent your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with
your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace to you all. Help us. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. I am the light of the world, says the Lord. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life.
Tuesday. Parish office hours will be 8 a.m. to 4:30 p.m. beginning Tuesday. The Thursday morning daily mass will be at 8:30 a.m. during the school year beginning this week. All faith formation groups will begin on Wednesday, September 14th, with mass at 6:30 p.m. On that night, registered students will receive a folder with their schedule. There is a list of registered students as well as schedules on the Faith Formation bulletin board in the back of the church.
Just a few words. So last night we had our men's gathering with the Exodus 90 representative, Nathaniel, who was here. You might have seen the big orange trailer within our parking lot over the last few days. Had a pretty good turnout from the guys of the parish and from surrounding parishes. And the speaker, Nathaniel, talked about Christian discipleship and the ways to get there through prayer, asceticism, and fraternity. So I think that's certainly applicable, not only for the guys of the parish, but for all of us as well. In addition to that, as you look at the bulletins for today, you see the beautiful cover there with representatives from Immaculate Conception School. Our school begins once again this Tuesday, and so we're thrilled after the summer hiatus to get back in action. We've been doing a lot of preparations with Mrs. Bona and the staff over the summer to get things ready with the physical structure and with the staff, and we're really looking forward to it. I know we have other teachers from other communities as well. Hopefully your preparations have gone well as you launch into this new academic year. For close to home here, for the school and for our church, you've seen the construction out on Central Avenue and various parts of the Heights. Well, that construction's coming really close to us, starting this week out on Jackson Street and on 41st for the next 2 weeks. The plan is that there's going to be construction there. And so we were told in a meeting with representatives of parish leadership, with those who are the contractors and working with the City of Columbia Heights, the roads will remain open. They'll close certain stretches at different times, but there will be access to our parking lot and to our church. And so just asking for your patience and perseverance here in the next couple of weeks as we get our roads back in tip-top shape. Just want to put that out there. So thank you again for your patience. With that, let us stand and pray. Grant that your faithful, O Lord, whom you nourish and endow with life through the food of your word and heavenly sacrament, may so benefit from your beloved Son's great gifts that we may merit an eternal share in his life, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Very good to pray with you all here this evening in church or virtually. Hope you have a great rest of this weekend. Enjoy Labor Day. Some of you have shared your adventures at the State Fair. If you happen to go there tomorrow or Labor Day, or even tonight after Mass, stay safe. Hopefully it's a very pleasant time for one and all. Again, for anyone who happens to be part of the liturgical celebration, it's your birthday today. You may be looking in your general direction. I hope you're enjoying your special day. Thank you for helping us out here. One other thing, so reflecting within the gospel for today about the different types of boats within the world, it reminded me, I don't know if you saw this news story, there's a group of sailors that built their boat out of diamonds. It was a real hardship The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Our final hymn is number 613, and we'll do verses 4 and 5.